All right, so we've been talking about so many different topics this evening, this whole day, right? We've been talking about how do you improve business models, revenue streams, profitability, improvement of the inclusion of AI in your current tech stacks, all of that. I'm going to talk about something a little different today. I'm going to talk about your IT teams, right? Your teams within your companies, which I'm sure all of you have IT representatives. In your company, you all have IT teams that are supporting your workers, that's your employees, whether they are in the office or outside the office, right? And I just want to do a quick raise of hands as if how many of us are fully remote or, you know, completely working from home today? Quick raise of hands. Okay, it's just about 2-3 people. Okay, and how many of us are hybrid in the room today? Okay, so that's about 50% of the room, and I think that'll I'll talk about some stats as we move forward, and you'll see that that's pretty much the generic you know, outlook of the world today, with about 50% of companies that are working hybrid. But a little bit about myself. I'm Natasha Rock. I'm the IT Solutions Group Lead with GoTo. If you're not sure who GoTo is, please come over. We have a big yellow shiny booth right at the start. So do come over and have a conversation. I have my sales team. My colleagues are here to discuss as well. But we've not, you know, although this is a startup summit, we're not really a startup per se. We've been around for 20 years. We were with a different brand called LogMeIn prior to GoTo. So some of you might be familiar with LogMeIn. We're a US-based company, pretty well-known in the remote support space for IT support, IT technology for your IT teams. But I'm not here to do a product pitch. I'm not here to talk about GoTo as much as I'm going to talk about the IT trends that are dominating the world today. So GoTo, in collaboration with Frost & Sullivan, so a lot of you might know who Frost & Sullivan is. They are a large-scale research company based out of the US. So we partnered with them to do some research to speak to IT leaders, right? IT leaders that could be your IT managers, your heads of IT, your VPs who manage your IT infrastructure within your company for your employees, or they manage your customer support, right? If you offer software, hardware to customers, they manage your support operations. So we, in collaboration with Frost & Sullivan, did some research and spoke to 1,000 different IT leaders across different industries, across different countries. And there are 5 major trends that we uncovered through that research. Starting with the number one priority for IT leaders was uncovered as maintaining hybrid work, right? And this might seem a little duh, like saying, yeah, we're all hybrid, yes, maintaining hybrid work. But for an IT leader, it's a completely different world, right? Where they had employees within an office that they could support, where they had somebody dropping into the second floor to troubleshoot their systems, and now they're supporting completely hybrid networks and hybrid workstations, which are so dynamic, right? The types of devices that we use, the networks that we are from, the locations that we are at are so different. And so that makes IT work a lot more complicated. And so maintaining hybrid work is one of the top priorities, being able to successfully keep employees productive, to keep them continuous in their work, to make sure that their work is not interrupted because of IT issues. That's a top priority for them. So 48% of respondents say that they're using an in-office work model, which means 52% still are working hybrid or they're working fully remote. So a lot of the SMBs, that is your less than 50 employee companies, were, you know, were quoted as saying that they prefer the in-office model, 100% from the office, but the rest of them, the remaining 52%, were all either hybrid or fully remote. So maintaining that work, making sure employees can continue to do their work without IT issues, as well as connecting employees to one another, right, in a virtual environment. Connecting employees to your customers and to your business partners, your vendors, your distributors. How do you connect them in a virtual world? So that's one of the top priorities. The next one is importance of consolidation. Right? Throughout the pandemic, a lot of businesses, especially SMBs, what they did is they weren't prepared for something at that scale. Right? So they didn't have the IT solutions in place. They didn't have the communication, collaboration tools in place to support hybrid work. So what they did is they went out and they had to buy a whole bunch of tools, right? They say, don't shop when you're hungry. That's exactly what they did, right? Because that was the need of the hour. They had to go out and buy a bunch of different tools because they needed to continue keeping their lights on. So they needed remote support technology for remotely troubleshooting issues. They needed collaboration tools like your Zoom, your Teams, for people to communicate with each other virtually. They needed all sorts. They needed security, they needed antivirus, they needed so many different things, which was, you know, was the need of the hour because they didn't have the luxury of an office to be able to control that. And so post-pandemic, that was last year, early last year, they woke up to a very different reality than they woke up to maybe 2 or 3 years ago, right? Where they had a bunch of different tools in their tech stack, a lot of them even redundant, right? A lot of them overlapping in purpose. A lot of them, they're spending 100% of the fee for the tool, but using only 20% of it. And so a lot of them chose to consolidate. So as of this year, since early last year, research says that they are looking to consolidate. They're looking to do away with all the redundancies in their tech stacks, and they're looking to bring that all into one platform, one vendor, one consolidated, unified view, pane of glass, for their IT admins, so that they can be more efficient in their IT work. Because as per the research, it said that IT administrators or technicians were spending 8 hours a week just switching applications, right? Because they had a separate tool for ITSM, they had a separate tool for CRM, they had a separate tool for collaboration, for security, for patch management, for remote support. So and this is just the world that we work within, right? I'm sure there are many other tools. And so all those tools were taking away 8 hours of productive time for IT agents having to switch between one app to the other. So data was siloed, as well as their work was being disrupted, right? They were not being as productive as they could have been if that was all consolidated on platformized models. So they're looking at consolidation. 90% of IT leaders are looking to consolidate this year. And 99% have already completed it or planned it, or it's in progress. The third major priority is reducing IT workloads, right? Because IT has become a lot more complex. Like I said, the locations, devices, operating systems, network bandwidths, all of that have become so dynamic, right? It's hard for an IT guy who's sitting in your, you know, in somewhere in supporting end users or your employees to be able to predict what the next issue is going to be, right? Because the end user could suddenly be working from a cab or from a cafe or from their hometown, which is an unknown network. So they would have to still support that employee or that customer no matter where they are, right? Because first call resolution, instant gratification, all of that is part of what our expectations are today as consumers. And so reducing IT workloads has become a top priority because IT has become a lot more complex. 89% of companies saw an increase in IT workloads in 2022, right? Because of how dynamic IT work has become. Switching vendors. So vendors that are not conducive to everything that I said so far, right? In terms of consolidation, in terms of saving time, making the agents more productive, maintaining hybrid work, all of that. If it's going to take away time from their daily productivity, make their work more complicated, then they're doing away with it. If it's a redundant tool that they could solve, like say, 20% of what they're using on that tool, if they can solve 100% of that on an existing tool which they already have, then why would they need that tool? They do away with it. Right? So they're looking at doing away with unnecessary software, unnecessary products which are in their tech stack, and looking to only focus on solutions that offer or augment their productivity and the ease of use and the time taken to solve issues, right? Because the focus is on the consumer, which could be the employee or could be the customer. Focus on the customer experience, like I said. So IT leaders are no longer just, you know, behind the scenes working on systems and infrastructure. They are now part of the business decision making in companies, right? They are also called business contributors or business leaders, and they contribute to the success of that company, where ROI and productivity and all of that is measured based on how effective the IT team is, right? How were they able to solve the issue in the first call? What was the average handling time? What's the CSAT scores that they are offering when they support customers? All these KPIs are part of the IT leader's stack of KPIs, and this is what they are measured against, and so they are part of the business decision making when business, you know, leaders have to decide on which technology do we invest in, where do we need to, you know, allocate funds. And so focus on the customer experience has become a priority for IT leaders, while it wasn't before, because what they do impacts the customer and impacts the employee. So 96% of organizations have increased their customer experience technology budget in 2023. So leaders have pretty much recognized the need for more investment, right? They need, IT needs more investment. If you want to do all those different things, then you've got to invest more in IT. And so they have started investing in tools that would do these five things, which is firstly enables hybrid work, reduces the IT workloads, all-in-one technology, consolidated platforms, affordable technology, because they want to get their bang for their buck, the value for money, but it should also be affordable, especially in this age of all the talk about the recession and with the inflation and all of the different market conditions. It has become a priority for technology to be affordable as well, while it should be powerful enough to do the rest and enhances customer experience. So now is the time for IT leaders to transform their IT. That's what they're looking at doing. And so just one quick introduction to GoTo. We're right here, like I said, big shiny booth. So drop in if you'd like to talk. But we've been around for 20 years. We were previously called as LogMeIn, like I said. We have two sides to our world. One is our collaboration suite, which is connecting employees to their customers. That is with our meeting tools, our webinar tools, our training tools. So we've got GoToMeeting, GoToWebinar, GoToTraining. Some of you might be familiar with them or even use them. That's part of our suite. And then on the right-hand side, we've got the GoToResolve, which is our IT tech stack, which is pretty much everything that I just said, right? All the five priorities that IT leaders are focused on: affordable remote support that would put one consolidated platform at the fingertips of your IT leaders to be able to solve every IT issue that your employees might have, your customers might have, as quick as possible on one platform. Whether it is remotely troubleshooting an issue on a Windows device, supporting a mobile, an iOS or an Android, doing your patch management, doing your alerts and monitoring, your hardware and asset inventory management, all of that, all your ITSM functions as well as your remote support, ticketing and all of that, part of one singular pane of glass, one platform called GoToResolve. We also have our enterprise-grade solution, which is a point solution, Rescue, LogMeIn Rescue, which is purely for remotely troubleshooting issues. So your employees, you traveling, have issues, you're not getting the support you need, maybe you all should consider using powerful remote support technology like Rescue, which would allow your IT agents to get a thorough understanding, firstly, of what's happening in the background on your machine through diagnostic information of what's your CPU utilization, what's your network bandwidth like, what's your memory capacity like, what are the tasks and applications running on your machine, all of that diagnostic information, and then being able to get in, solve that issue, and get out as quickly as possible so that you, as business leaders, can continue to do your productive work. Right, so that's pretty much GoTo, and that's all I'm going to talk about GoTo. If you're still curious, please come over. We have a very colorful booth, as you would have noticed. And I hope this was an insightful discussion for all of you, a presentation for all of you. So if you have any questions, I'm happy to take them now. If not, I'm pretty much done. So thanks. Thank you, everyone.